late start. We've had a crazy morning. I watched a guy drive off of the road. Just veer off of the road up onto a power line, and it's been a really weird morning. But happy holidays. We're so glad you're here. Today we are so excited to have Marielle Bachman up here to present BellyLaugh teas and supplements. Our coworker, and she's actually pretty amazing. So I think I'll just kind of start off with that. There's other things I'm going to mention. Somebody actually vandalized our building, and if you saw the posters that are on the front of the building, we do not support that. We are not going to even talk about what the conflict in Palestine. But if you know who did it, let us know. But we do not support that, and they're getting removed. Anyways, without further ado, Marielle Bachman and BellyLaugh Teas and Supplements.
So I went to school in New York City during college, and before that I was always like a very happy-go-lucky, energetic person, very joyful. I had a nice like set group of friends. After college, I decided to stay in Brooklyn to continue living there, and it was over the course of those years after college that kind of just the stress of that fast-paced lifestyle started to catch up with me. I didn't realize it at the time, but you know, I was drinking tons of coffee, I was drinking tons of alcohol, I was dehydrated, and I was really living in a state of chronic stress. If you were around in 2015 to 18, people were popping antibiotics like it was their job. Any sort of illness I was taking antibiotics for, and just slowly over the years, my mental health was just kind of getting a little bit worse and worse. That joyful, happy person, I didn't really see her anymore. I was feeling confused as to what was happening. I wanted to get back to who I was, but I didn't exactly know how. In 2017, I underwent a couple of surgeries on my foot, pretty intensive, and I was given two rounds of really intense antibiotics that totally wiped out my gut microbiome, and that was really the straw that broke the camel's back. After that, my already declining mental health totally plummeted. I was absolutely depressed. We can go to the next slide, actually. You know, the light in my eyes had gone out. I was super anxious all the time. As you can see here, I was undergoing a lot lot of inflammation. My skin had erupted into a situation called rosacea. Doctors were like, we don't really know, and you're just gonna have to live with this for the rest of your life. It was so painful. I was really upset. I didn't recognize myself in the mirror. Like, the light in my eyes had gone out. My face was completely foreign. It was obviously very upsetting, and I couldn't eat any of my favorite foods. So I was drinking coffee and alcohol before. I couldn't even drink a cup of coffee or look at a glass of alcohol. I couldn't eat anything except for what I was calling the baby food diet. If I kind of veered from this, it sent me into this couple of days of like agony and pain. And it was really confusing. So I did what most people would do. Went to a bunch of doctors, talked to a gastroenterologist to figure out what was going on. Found a great doctor who was able to diagnose me. And over the course of 3 months, after a lifetime of not having any chronic illness, I was diagnosed with three chronic illnesses over the course of 3 months. So we can hit the next slide. So the first tier I'm calling was all based around my gut, as you would imagine. So the first diagnosis I received was gastritis, and the second was gastric ulcer. A gastric ulcer, gastritis, and ulcers, for those who aren't familiar, basically inflammation of the gut lining. There's been damage done to the mucous membrane that is protecting the gut lining from pathogens and other unwanted cells from entering. If that gets intense enough, basically an ulcer forms where there's a perforation in the gut lining, allowing even more pathogens to enter the bloodstream. So when that's happening, you could also refer to it as leaky gut. It causes system-wide inflammation because there are particles and cells that are entering the bloodstream when they're not supposed to. Your immune system is lowered, your microbiome is even further disrupted, and it's going to cause a bunch of random food sensitivities like ones that you didn't have before. So that's related to the second tier of diagnosis, which was unrelated to my gastric issues, but I was diagnosed with rosacea, like I mentioned, in bipolar 2. So rosacea, I was experiencing inflammation of the face when I was stressed and when I had any sort of trigger foods. And I was diagnosed with bipolar, which is basically when you undergo periods of depression with like short bouts of mania. So both of these were pretty shocking to me. I never had chronic illness. Rosacea, these things don't run in my family, and both of them I was told I was going to be on prescription medications for the rest of my life. So I was putting creams on my face to get rid of the redness. I was taking, well, I took it for a little bit, and I was like, I don't like the way this makes me feel, but these lithium mood stabilizers that are supposed to make you feel normal, but they made me feel like even further from myself. So the reason why these two things, as I later discovered, are related, are because, like I mentioned, if there are pathogens and particles entering the bloodstream before they're supposed to be, it's going to cause system-wide inflammation, and that was showing up in my face as rosacea. And also, in the gut is where serotonin, which is like a mood regulator and stabilizer, that's where that neurotransmitter is created and stored in the mucous membrane. So my mucous membranes were obviously super damaged. I wasn't storing enough serotonin, I wasn't producing enough serotonin, so obviously my moods were going to be completely out of whack. So we can hit the next slide. So all of these things that I was diagnosed with, I was given very short-term band-aid solutions. I was popping Tums like it was my job. I was eating PPIs, which kept me from producing acid, which is a very natural thing for your body to do to break down food. I was, you know, teetering between taking mood stabilizers, and I was putting prescription things like creams on my face. I wanted to heal. I didn't want to just mask my symptoms. So what I did is that I, as a very self-starter, self-motivated, do-it-yourself kind of person, I dove into studies myself. So I launched into the next slide about 500 plus hours of studies in herbalism, in nutrition, in health coaching, Ayurvedic studies. I have a background in yoga teaching certification and meditation, so I kind of use those as a jumping off point. I've always been interested in like herbal medicine and skincare, so I decided why not apply these studies to myself and figure out what's really going on. At the time, the mind-gut connection didn't have that much press. It's getting more popular now, but all of these studies led me to this very, very important link between the brain and the belly. So what is the mind-gut connection? The mind-gut connection is a complex set of neurons and neurotransmitters and hormones that allow for communications between your brain and your gut. Go to the next slide. So what it is responsible for is mood, appetite and cravings, memory, sleep, even your personality in the way that you think. We'll go to the next one. I don't know if there's a way that, okay, thank you. So a key player in the process of why the gut is helping to moderate all of these things is serotonin production, like I mentioned before. Serotonin is going to be produced by a very healthy microbiome that is receiving foods called prebiotics. So if you feed your healthy little gut bacteria's nice prebiotic foods, they're going to produce what is called the happy hormone, serotonin. It's going to help you feel good, it's going to help you focus, it's going to help give you emotional stability, which I was lacking, sleep, digestion, wound healing, and the like. So why is this all important? Basically, gastritis and ulcer equals damage to the mucosal layer. So inflammation, rosacea, and disrupted microbiome. So that mucosal layer was allowed for pathogens to enter the bloodstream. That causes chronic inflammation. That chronic inflammation is going to disrupt my microbiome. A disrupted microbiome is therefore disrupted serotonin production and storage, bipolar. And from there, impact on the mood, the personality, sleep, and immune system. During this time, I was getting sick like every 2 weeks. And living in New York City, there's a lot of bugs going around, and I was always the first to get them. So as you can see, we can hit the next one. Your gut health plays an enormous role in your personality and in your mental health, and the two of them need to be treated and supported together. They are not two separate entities, but they are one and the same. So, the problem, gastrointestinal disease, one of the leading causes of it is stress. 60 to 70 million Americans in 2022 were suffering from GI disease, enough to the point where it disrupted them from their daily habits and daily life. Of those people, 60% of them had psychological or psychiatric disorders, and those are only the people that actually went to the doctor to get diagnosed. So you can imagine it's probably more. Go to the next one. Well, probiotic supplements are super popular these days. You see them everywhere. They're great, but they tend to just be an expensive solution to not really addressing the root of the problem. The way that I like to think about it is you can keep on adding people to the house, but if the house is on fire, those people are not going to do very well. So the solution is, we can hit the next slide, heal the house. So by strengthening the mucous membranes of the digestive system, by strengthening the stress response, and by feeding existing and new healthy bacteria to reestablish the microbiome, you can restore balance in both the digestive and nervous systems simultaneously. Introducing BellyLaugh. So herbs for happy, healthy bellies. So a culmination of all of these studies and all of these trial and errors over 3 years, I developed a line of products called BellyLaugh. Next one. Here's some of the products that I've created. I've done the branding and the logos as a graphic designer and brand strategist. I did all the formulas and I sourced all of the herbs from super reputable sources. Some of them are here in Asheville and some of them are like sources in the United States, like Mountain Rose Herbs, that are known for their to give back to the community and for their sustainability impact. So all of the herbs are super thoughtfully sourced and are all completely organic. So we can go to the next one. Here's the product line, which launched on October 1st. There are 2 teas and 2 capsules. Make the tea blends myself. I also make the capsule blends myself, and I package all those little pills with a fancy little thing called the pill press, which I brought, and I'm gonna show it like on the table after some people are curious about it. I'm not gonna do a demo, but I have the little machines if you wanna check it out. So here's the 4 products. We have some more ongoing, like long-term care that you can take every day on the left, and more acute care on the right-hand side. Go to the next one. So I won't like get into all of this. You can kind of read through the ingredients and what the core actions of each of the products are, but basically what the entire product line and what the BellyLaugh products do is that they're going to soothe stress, they're going to ease stress levels, they're going to increase the stress response and the ability to respond to stress, ease inflammation, boost the immune system, and most importantly, they're going to repair, rebuild the mucous membranes in order to support the nervous and digestive system. The mucous membranes of the digestive So here we go. Relieve mental symptoms of stress, repair the, or better the stress response, reduce inflammation, support the nervous system, enhance the immune system, and rebuild the mucosal membranes of the digestive tract. So with sensitive individuals in mind, BellyLaugh is only going to use ingredients that are healing, nourishing, and soothing, and that are never drying, harsh, or stimulating. The nature of the body and all of our body's core desire is to find homeostasis, and that is a natural process that all of our bodies go through, is to constantly find homeostasis. So the herbs that BellyLaugh uses aren't going to dramatically alter or change the composition of the body, but rather they're going to support your body to create an environment where it is better able to find its homeostasis naturally and effectively. So you can take my word for it, or you can check out some of the reviews on my website. So I've been open for a couple months, and I already have some really awesome feedback. People love the flavor of the teas. They've incorporated the capsules into their daily ritual and routine. Their immune systems are responding better. They're not getting sick. They have less inflammation. They feel better. They're less stressed. So these products work. They're really unique, and I've spent 3 years formulating them. It's been a passion project through and through. So I'm just happy to see people that they're liking it as well. So again, graphic designer. I just love the whole visual and web-like presence aspect of building a brand, as well as the herbs. So this is exciting. I get to blend my two passions together. Here's me, a little GIF, filling out the Nourish blend. And then this is a picture of the bestsellers. I like created a little backdrop and went and picked those flowers from a local flower farm and did an awesome photo shoot with a friend of mine. So Rebuild and Nourish here, definitely the bestsellers. And this is probably like one of my favorite photos that we've taken for the product so far, although we have some more product photography and ideas bouncing around. We can go to the next one. So some of the values of BellyLaugh. I think that when you are more connected to yourself, you can also be more connected to the planet. So for that reason, I want all packaging and shipping materials to be sustainable. Plastic is cheaper, yes, but I'm trying to avoid it. The only plastic I really use is the tape that's taping down, like the shipping labels and maybe the labels themselves. Everything else is going to be recyclable, compostable, or reusable. Like I mentioned before, and thoughtfully sourced organic herbs. Unique blends. I've spent a long time formulating. The blends are unlike anything else I've seen on the market, so I'm proud of what I've created here, especially as someone who loves to cook. I kind of look at the herbs, especially with the tea blends, kind of from this like chef's perspective and balancing the flavor profiles. So scientifically backed, I love to do my research and make sure that everything is going to be backed by science, but then also energetically grounded. So for my herbalist friends in the audience, energetics are super important to herbalism, and it's something that I really want to maintain as I continue to grow. I listen to soothing music as I make the blends. If I'm touching the herbs in any way, I'm always in a place where I'm feeling very grounded and I'm not stressed and I'm thinking positive thoughts, because I believe that that's going to be transposed, like it's going to be sent into whoever's going to take those blends. So I'd love to maintain that value as I continue to grow. So as I continue to grow, what's the plan? So for the short term, 1 to 3 years, I would love to expand the team. Like right now, it's just me and my friend who helps me with photography. I would love to have somebody help with operations and outreach. I'd love to get a wholesale footing in like the local co-ops and maybe even Whole Foods if I'm lucky. I want to get a strong foothold in the e-com space. The whole point of BellyLaugh originally was to have an e-commerce platform. I love to travel. I want to be able to travel, and I want to have like a business that's able to kind of like run itself and kind of ship products off where I'm not exchanging my time for money like I have been with design. I would love to create and continue creating a strong presence on social media and be considered a thought leader like in the herbalism and mind gut space. And lastly, to expand the product line with some other products that are related to stress and digestion. So we can have the last one. So that leads me to you guys. I would love to kind of bump this into your direction as 1 million cups goes. I have two specific questions. I'm also open to answering questions. The first question is, I would love some advice on how to enter the market as a reputable source for people that have been diagnosed with inflammatory gut illness. This is really the reason I started this. I would have loved to have some brand like BellyLaugh find me as I was experiencing inflammation and like food sensitivities. It's hard to really get into that market without like stepping on the toes of medical professionals who are super talented and have so much to offer. I also don't want to get into murky legal territory. So if you guys have any suggestions on maybe how to enter that market in a way that feels grounded and safe, super open to it. Another one is how to stand out in a sea of online retailers, especially for herbs and kind of like this new gut health wave that's happening. I would love some advice on just kind of how to be a little bit different and how to hold my own. But I'm also open to answering questions of yours, and yeah, thank you so much for listening.
So I love this. Great. As somebody who will be a customer of yours, I'm wondering if you've thought about almost like a intake questionnaire or some sort of, like, when I look at your products, it's amazing. How do I know which one I should be drawn toward? Like some sort of symptom checker, kind of, not to be WebMD, but something like that that would point me in the right direction. That might be really helpful.
Yes, definitely. I want to do like some sort of quiz. First, but I would love to have some sort of like quiz integration to help one sort of like gamify it where people are engaged and then also to help, yeah, point people in the right direction. Thank you. Oh, sorry, hello. I don't think this is on anymore.
about a marketing plan and how you support that marketing plan before you spend too much money.
Thank you. Yeah, a lot of the growth I'm trying to do right now is just organic, like on Instagram and TikTok is something I'm going to be exploring, and it's just going to be my face blasted on these platforms, which isn't ideal, but I'm going to do it. I also have 3 jobs right now, which is helping me support this. Yeah, so this is one job, and I have 2 other jobs. So that's what's helping income happen. I'm trying not to spend too much on marketing, but I would love to like save up to work with somebody who's a professional like in marketing and kind of have different ideas about angles I can pursue, but then which one is going to get the best feedback. And yeah, so thank you so much for your feedback.
And there's a lot of mentoring available at no cost to your management. Mm-hmm. Excellent mentoring. Business mentoring.
Do you have any recommendations of resources?
I work with Mountain BizWorks, I work with SCORE, I work with the Industrial Extension. It's a federal program who gets a lot of funding from the Department of Commerce. I can think of more. AB Tech has their startup program. So I would try to link in to, I feel like my business would never have gotten off the ground without the kind of business support that's available here in Nashville at low to no cost. And it's better. There's so many PhDs and extremely successful retirees that have moved here.
Can anybody that is with one of those support organizations raise their hand right now? Let's get higher.
Hi.
No, okay, let's chat. They're here to help you. And anybody that is starting business.
Yeah, there's also a program called Inspire through the Chamber that check out. It's for companies that are younger than 2 years, and it is an accelerator program as well. Jeff Kaplan is here to represent that.
It's Insight.
It's called Insight, thank you.
Oh, right. Yeah. I need to write all of these down at some point, so maybe afterwards.
Yeah,
okay, we'll get that. Thank you. Live stream
reports.
Yeah. That's
right.
Just, yeah.
Cool. Hi. Thank you for your presentation. Thank you for sharing your story. I'm actually drinking your tea a lot, your Hatch, and so thank you for providing that. Yeah, both on Mrs. Abbott, and it's phenomenal.
Yeah.
So thank you. Your second question, which was something along the lines of like how to get more customers, like what to do, and kind of where to go. A thought here is I think you have a pretty unique differentiator if you go hyper local, because you're literally making the things and packaging them in Nashville, and you have kind of the organic creds and those kind of things, and then paired with your kind of let's just say supportive energetics. I think all of that is a very, very, very good differentiator for the Asheville local markets. So I think your plan to kind of go into co-ops and really go into any place that will put your tea on its shelves or on its counters is a worthwhile thing to prioritize, because I think it just checks a lot of boxes for folks in Asheville looking for something hyper local, looking for something that's done with care, and so that's, I think that would be a good thing to prioritize, and then you can build off that as you kind of scale statewide or globally or across the country. It's like, well, it has footing in Asheville, which has its own kind of mystique and brand, as it were. So anyway, good luck. Thank you for the presentation.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thanks for your presentation. That was great. I have very boring questions about pricing and cost structure and how you would potentially maintain your production process if you personally don't have to do it.
Ooh, interesting. So the prices range from $18 to $22. The more acute care, I believe it's like $18 to $19, and then Nourish, I believe, is $22, Rebuild is $21. Something like that. I've been playing with the prices incrementally. As far as maintaining production when I'm making the products, was that the question? Can you repeat that second part there?
just you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If you want to go on to grow the business, who will make the products in the future, and how will you transfer this teaching onto them and maintain a cost structure that can like withstand wholesale accounts?
Yes, good question, thank you. Might have to ponder on this one a little bit more. I'm still such a little baby, so I haven't really thought about that whole process, but I guess as far as making sure that people have the same, have like herbal backgrounds, right? Like there are so many herbalists here in Asheville that would love to work in the industry. Maybe they don't want to launch their own product line, but I know for a fact that if you went to any of these herbalism schools in Asheville, like I did, like you're learning about plant energetics, and you know, odds are is that it's important for you to maintain that type of integrity in your work. So I guess just like vetting people and making sure that we have similar backgrounds and education. Maybe doing some sort of like education program or something, and then having students, you know, this is all just coming to me off the top of my head, but I think there are ways to do it to make sure that like employees of BellyLaugh are, you know, they have the same values as I do.
Hey, I'm Holly. I just want to applaud you for where you are right now. It's amazing. I mean, you've come quite a journey through there, and you're doing amazing things with it, so congratulations. I have some thoughts, lots of thoughts, but it strikes me this is not a pop a pill and you're healed. This is one aspect of a holistic lifestyle shift, right?
Yes.
That you've no doubt gone through in your food and, you know, absolutely everything. So how do you come into a collective, you know, get out of your silo, get into a roundtable, integrated kind of approach where the center focus is gut health and mental health, which is getting more and more attention, and then docking in with other trusted authorities in that field where people are already thinking about this stuff, like the Zach Bush and Farmer's Footprint that's all about getting rid of glyphosate and the leaky gut and the tight juncture disruption and all of that. Zen's amazing group on across America, they're all about, you know, how we're shifting our diets and how it impacts our health and our mental state, all that sort of thing. So getting in with those big players that already have that established credibility and they're already talking to people who get it, who are like, oh my gosh, yes, I need this. And I love the hyper-local about how you get a cadre of partners that are aligned, like a spice walla or the chestnuts soup, and really aligned with the people that are already catering to these people that care about what you care about and what you're a solution for, rather than trying to duke it out on TikTok and Instagram, because you're just in a, you know, a red ocean there of just like all the players are there. And you know, so in a hyperlocal, I could even see you have, you know, maybe a membership model that local members, herbalists, or people that just love herbs come and play amazing music and talk together in this incredible energy while they're helping you press bills. And you know, there's so many things that could be done as you start to align with all the key players of that puzzle.
That's awesome. Thank you so much. I appreciate that.
We have time for one more question.
Okay, if I can go. Although it's actually not a question, I do have a recommendation. But first, I thank you for your presentation. I wanted to compliment your stage presence. Mm-hmm. Very solid, engaging, good connection.
Yeah.
I wanted to second the reference to AB Tech. You know, every community college in North Carolina has a small business center. They have different specialties. And the one that serves Buncombe and Mitchell focuses on food and beverage. So if anybody's in that business and you, I would definitely speak with them and see how they can help you. So my recommendation, I noticed that bellylaugh.com without the hyphen doesn't appear to be registered.
It's $7,000.
I do that. What was that?
It's $7,000.
Oh.
It's what?
It's $7,000 to buy bellylaugh.com. So
it's not returning anything. You're saying it's already registered?
I believe that. Yeah, I have to buy it. So somebody like owns it, and then they're...
Let's talk about that. I'm confused. I don't want to... I'm not getting a hit on bellylaugh.com.
It's not taken, but it has been, like, harvested.
The premium domains, you have to pay more than just your typical...
$10 a year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Someone else owns it.
Well, that... Well,
and they have it for sale.
And isn't using it at all. I'm sorry to hear that.
I know. It's such
stunning.
There you go. So coming up next week, we're gonna do a recap of the entire year. And we're also gonna play some fun games. It's gonna be a great way to engage. Giveaways, so much fun. So return next week and bring all your friends. How many people is this their first time coming to 1 Million Cups? Yeah, thank you for coming. Glad you're here. And how many people have been more than 5 times? We love that you guys keep coming, thank you. And if you know of anybody that wants to present, we're now booking into February, so good things. We are only going to be taking 2 weeks off over the holidays, so next week is going to be a lot of fun, show up for that, and then we'll go celebrate. Big thanks to Charlie and Troy Ball for generously donating the space each week, Inside Edge Consulting, SCORE, Mike Trufa in the back, great resource, the Hatch Foundation, we've got Eileen and Jay right here, so if you have questions about which is the right group to connect with, like, I think that kind of came up. Mountain BizWorks, people are throwing out all of the names. Talk to Jay, talk to Eileen, they can help steer you in the right direction. Eli, the computer guy, he makes all of the delicious treats each week. Annie Lewis, Biz Radio, Venture Asheville, Edward Jones, the Hatch Coworking, WNC Business, Mountain BizWorks, Big C, Dynamite Coffee Roasting, Viking Mergers and Acquisitions, and big shout out to Tony who makes our coffee each week. If you have a mug, return it. Do not walk into co-working. I still find them there. So next week is going to be the holiday party with the end of year recap. Then this Thursday, UNCA is doing their imagine of the UNCA space. So they are moving into the end of the building with the entrepreneurship lab. And all the students are bringing their ideas about what would be the best use of the space. So that is at noon. There's going to be snacks, drinks, that sort of thing. Brian is back there. Raise your hand, Brian. Yeah, so totally free. Come. It's noon to 1:30? Noon to 1:30. And then also, later on that night is the Uglier Sweater Party. And I think it's pretty cute though. I think it's pretty cute with your Snoopy sweater. And then we have our holiday gala at the Marquee on Saturday. And coming up next week is the Venture 15 Award. I want to say thank you to anybody that nominated us for that. Like we are nominated, and I just thank you, big shout out. Like it means so much to us. Anyways, get your tickets now because it will sell out, and tickets are $40. It's always a great time. It's Jeff Kaplan's time of the entire year to shine. He puts on an incredible show, I have to say. And I wanted to give the mic up to Eileen. Eileen, will you come up here? Because the Hatch Foundation is hiring a program manager.
I'm Eileen Hutchison. I'm a board member of the Hatch Foundation, and we are a completely volunteer-run organization, but that's challenging, as you can well imagine. And we utilize several contract employees, one being Isaac Dunn over here, who manages all our communications. And we are now going to hire a program manager, and this will be somebody who can help organize and plan and execute and track all of our events. If you are interested or you know anybody who would be interested, please go to our website, hatchinnovationhub.org. There's a pop-up that will take you to the job description. And please spread the word because we're a fun group and it'll be a wonderful job for somebody. And appreciate your help.
To Zen Honeycutt, who has been going viral for all of her hard work on kind of exposing what is it. Yeah, like seriously, everybody should really clap. If you haven't seen what Zen's been up to, it's all over the internet. She's been featured on some pretty amazing shows and been traveling a lot. Exposing what's in fast foods and just kind of bringing it to everyone's attention because it's sometimes easy to stop at Chick-fil-A or Taco Bell, but at least
least you know what you're doing now, you know? Thank you, Zen. Thank you for all you do. All right, so holiday recap next week. We'll see you here. Thanks so much for coming, and have an awesome day. Happy holidays.